Good afternoon, everybody. I am the Cynic, and no, I'm not back. I just make videos when I please and when I have something to say. And today, I've got to address an issue I've been seeing time and time again in the debate against feminism and its failing talking points. As I'm sure all of you are aware, Jordan Peterson was recently on Channel 4 News in a debate with Kathy Newman about the alleged gender inequality in society. In this debate, it was an obvious blowout in favor of Peterson. Anybody and their mother could see the good psychologist wrecked Newman and her constant strawmanning of his position. Every other one of her sentences starting out with, "So you're saying is," and followed by enough intellectually dishonest trite that would make even Onision blush. Now, while Peterson held his own quite well, there was one big part of the debate that stuck out to me more than anything else. And no, it wasn't the lobster thing, as odd as that was, but when Kathy Newman first complained about generalizations made by Peterson in terms of women wanting strong partners, and then again when she made a complaint about generalization in her saying, quote, "Again, a vast generalization, isn't it?" in pertinence to the women, to the point that women, on average, display a personality trait known as agreeableness, and that's why they get paid less. And Jordan replies, quote, "It's not a generalization." Actually, yes, Mr. Peterson, it is a generalization. It's the application of a general rule of women being more agreeable than men and using that as the basis for the earnings gap. It's a generalization. Both of them are correct on this. However, there's a word missing from both of them. And for Newman, that word is sweeping or hasty in terms of generalization. And for Peterson, it would be statistical or valid generalization. The hasty and sweeping generalizations are logical fallacies in their lack of comprehension or study towards any specific effect or phenomena, and using a small sample size or example, and applying this under representative observation to apply to the wider whole. For example, if you only ever see people with one leg because one of their legs was cut off and you're in some area where that's the case, it would be a hasty generalization to say that human beings only have one leg, pointing to the exception as the norm instead of the rule. Now, if you were to observe both the people with one leg and the wider whole of humanity, and see that the vast majority of humans have two legs, and observe the empirical numbers and data to show that two-legged people are far more represented than one-legged people, it would be a statistical generalization to conclude that humans had two legs as a rule, and those with one leg were the exception. And this is one of the issues I take with the debate. But I've got another that infuriates me all the same. The entire debate, and I mean quite literally, the entire debate is predicated on generalizations. Men get paid more than women? As what if not a generalization exactly? Statistical generalization, yes, but it's a generalization. Not to mention Kathy seems very much to like generalizing when it suits her. Every time she opens her mouth and starts out with the word women, it's an automatic generalization, and as she's typically inferring to how women, as a monolith, as a general collective, would see and feel in any scenario or event in which she is speaking about. This video isn't just about Peterson, though. But for every time I see a social justice type decry generalization and the missed opportunity therein by their opponent to remind said social justice warrior about the fact that their entire position stems from one generalization on top of another. White privilege, male privilege, anything that encompasses any particular group is a generalization. So I don't know why people aren't going off about this whenever one of these types screams fucking generalization. You could easily throw that right back in their face. And that's if I was in Mr. Peterson's shoes, that's what I would have done. And that's really my only complaint with him, and aside from the lobster thing. People, that's not an argument. Saying generalization, saying that's a generalization, isn't it? Is not an argument, because yeah, it's a generalization, but We're talking in general rules. 9 times out of 10, saying that's a generalization isn't an argument. Generalizations aren't bad or inherently dishonest. Matter of fact, when talking about such broad topics like culture or economics, where factors and variables are almost countless in their influence, generalizations are a necessary part of making any determination. And anybody who fails to understand this, yet participates in the argument, is either willfully ignorant or intellectually dishonest and should be exposed as such. I am the cynic, everybody. Have a nice day.